So here's a quick demo of how we're gonna create our fixed point at the top of the mast with our hooks here. So the hook will be hoisted and then clamped on the pin. And that's pretty straightforward. Then now you will have your fixed point at the top, and then you can create tension at the bottom either with a purchase system like this, 3-to-1, 2-to-1, or hydraulic ram. So that's what you will do here. Create your tension so you have less compression in the mast and very small halyards, so no weight in your mast. So it's of course important that the mast manufacturer has planned all kind of reinforcement to work with the loads involved with the size of the hook. So the second point in installation is that we want to have a proper distance between the pin and the fixed point. So we'll have to use this type of high load lashing, and as you see, this will be giving a distance of about 15 centimeters from the mast. So this will prevent our pin to just have shocks and in the mast. We can have a protecting pad as well here. And it will be the same for the halyard coming from the bottom. And you will request about 15 to 20 centimeters to make sure your halyard works with a proper angle without, once it's locked, you don't want your swivel to be in contact with the mast. What we really want to see when installing the halyard is to have, of course, halyard diameter as requested in the charts and the catalog, to make sure it slides properly into the hook here. At the end, we will have a T-bone with a splice, and I think that's just our first size. The 1.5 is with a knot, and all the other sizes above will have a T-bone like this. So the T-bone will be in fact sliding locked here when the halyard would be sliding into the hook. Thank you for following us on our YouTube Karver channel, and you can like and share our videos on Facebook. Thank you.